The Tao of Self-Confidence, Episode 338.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to the Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have a phenomenal woman on the show today. She is a blogger and also a social influencer, and I'm really excited to have her on the show today to share her story on self-confidence. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Jess Estrada. Jess, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more about yourself to our listeners.
Hi, Sheena. Thanks for having me. Again, I'm Jess Estrada. I am a Seattle-based lifestyle blogger, and I do quite a bit of work in social media. I also have a day job doing digital media management for a nonprofit family foundation. But I've been in the blogging and social media sphere for almost a decade now, whether it's professionally or personally. So happy to be here tonight to talk about self-confidence.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Jess, what's your cultural background?
So I'm a first generation Filipino American. My parents came here, both came here separately in the 70s. And they met, for those of you who are in Seattle or know Seattle, they met at Cleveland High School in the Beacon Hill neighborhood. I was born and raised here in Seattle, and I'm very grateful to still be living in the city. We just bought our townhome last month.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And what would be your favorite self-confidence quote?
My favorite self-confidence quote is act as if. And my one internship during college was for the Downtown Seattle Association. And my boss there, he would always coach me and mentor me in different situations. And his favorite kind of piece of advice was the quote, act as if, which he says he got from the movie Boiler Room. But it's not so much pretending to be someone else, but really thinking through the qualities or the skills of something that you want to be or aspire to. So in my case, when I was an intern for my boss, he would coach me on job interviews for when I actually had to do them after my internship. And so he told me to act as if I already had the job that I was applying for and to kind of just think through situations and how I would carry myself in those specific situations if I already had that job. So I've taken that with me for the many years since that internship, and I use it again and again to kind of think through when I'm prepping for speeches or for writing blog posts or going, public speaking gigs. Anytime I need a pick me up, I like to think of that quote and think of my intern boss and how he would coach me through that. So
thanks for sharing that. And that's a great quote. I mean, it's not, when we learn to just act as if we were that person, or if we were like the confident person to get the job, to get the, company that we want, or business, or just anything that we want to be, when we can learn to act as if, our brain is so powerful, it's going to start picking up those things and start attracting the right things into our life. So I really like that quote that you mentioned. And in your own words, how would you define self-confidence?
I like to think of self-confidence more of like a muscle. I work out a lot, and so I know, just like anyone else who works out a lot, that it takes a lot of repetition and constant work to build up the strength of a muscle, and I look at self-confidence in the same way. It's really easy to lose the strength that we've built, and it's so painful because we work so hard, whether it's to build up our physical strength or our self-confidence, and it's so easy to lose it with one bad review at work, or one bad comment on my blog, or one, just bad anything that you see on social media or online, or that anyone says to you. It's really easy to get knocked off our pedestal, so to speak, and for our self-confidence to wane. And so as silly as it might sound to some people, I think I hold things like self-care and positive self-talk really highly, and I make it a priority. And When you work on things like that, you are able to build that trust in yourself, and that trust in yourself, that positive self-talk, and that constant self-care. Those are really the foundations, I think, of what makes self-confidence. And those are the things that I turn to whenever I doubt myself or I feel really overwhelmed with life or just defeated by what's going on out there. It's really easy to doubt your skills and capabilities, but when you think back and work on those things, that's really what helps build back up your self-confidence.
Thanks for sharing that. And that's a great definition that you shared with us. I also believe self-care is really important. I mean, you know, we live in a world, you know, maybe growing up as an Asian woman or, you know, an Asian child, it's like we've been prone to like always take care of others and we forget to take care of ourselves, which is really our number one priority. And it doesn't mean that you're selfish. It just means you love yourself enough to take care of yourself so that you can spread the love, right? Once that happens. So thanks for sharing that great definition. And Jess, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
I think it was really easy. Like you said, we spend so much time, Asian women in particular, we spend a lot of our time caring and going out of our way to take care of other people. I think my life before really channeling into my self-confidence was about kind of finding energy and my self-definition in other people also. So I looked to others to create that perception of who I was as a person and what kinds of things I should be doing with my life. It starts with your parents telling you you should go into certain kinds of fields of study at college and what kinds of jobs you should take on. And it kind of just grows from there. And everyone around us, I think that they think that they're well-meaning, but a lot of times you can lose yourself in other people's opinions of who you are. And it's also easier to look outwards than to turn inwards and really listen to your inner intuition and to trust that self-confidence of, you know, who you are and what you should be in life.
Thanks for sharing that. And, you know, it's easy to like listen to other people's opinions. Like it's fine when people tell you what to do, but it's ultimately up to you to take that action or not. Just because they tell you that, you know, you should be this or you should be that doesn't mean you have to go out there and do it. And I think a lot of women suffer from that because they feel like if they don't do a certain thing that people tell them, then they're not that good person, or they're a failure, or they feel like they're not worthy. And then all the self-esteem issues start to come out, right? But like, what was that point in your life when you realized that, you know, you can be the person you are today, do the things that you love, and yeah, have that confidence? What was that aha moment?
I definitely was pushed into the aha moment I can think of. I left a job that I just was really unhappy with and had been for a long time. And it was kind of a mutual like parting of ways. So I didn't know what my next steps would be. Even though I was unhappy, I was just kind of going through the motions of being there. And it was so scary at first because I'd never been in a position professionally of not having my next steps in place or a next job and whatnot. But there was something deep inside of me that really wanted to just see what I was made of as far as professional blogging goes. And by then I'd already been blogging for like 4 years. And so blogging was also taking off as far as like brands taking notice of working with bloggers and handing out contracts and things like that. So that was really, leaving my job was really the fire that sparked listening to myself and what I really wanted to do with my life. And the next 2.5 years that followed that, it was a constant journey of channeling my self-confidence to make my biggest dreams come true. And all of the big ideas I had around my blog, there was really no one else to make them happen except for me. And on the side, I would also take on consulting projects and freelance work, which was the first time I'd ever done any of that. So you're kind of always on the hustle and you really need your self-confidence to be high to help kind of buoy you and your energy through that process. So it was really probably the scariest time for me professionally, but also the most exhilarating and the most exciting.
That's pretty awesome. And, you know, I know it's scary to leave a job, right? Because of that uncertainty, right? Like we've been so used to like knowing what our next step is. And when you leave a job and you don't know what's going to happen, it's like, oh my God, you start to get scared, you start to get worried, but you embraced it, right? You embraced that certainty. You just kept on going. You knew there was something bigger out there for you and you just went for it, which is great. And, you know, because it's so rare for people to do that nowadays, you know, they just feel like a job is the answer. And I'm not saying having a job is bad, but if it's a job that's not for you, then, you know, then that's when you have to go out there and do something that you love. And because of this realization, what's your life been like now?
It's still evolving. It's definitely, self-confidence is something where you just kind of have ups and downs related to it. I've had a ton of highs, a lot of, I don't want to call them lows, so I'll call them learning opportunities. And it's just, I'm always amazed at how I can look back at times when I was just so full of self-confidence and so full of trust in myself. And in that present moment, I'm feeling low or depressed or just, you know, that I'm not doing enough or that I'm a failure. I'm amazed that I still feel like that, but I shouldn't be, because sometimes we get into places in our life where we do get complacent or we just get overwhelmed by everything that's going on. But at the end of the day or any situation, I always find my way back to the things that help me build my self-confidence back up. So that self-care and making that a priority and constant positive self-talk, hanging out with friends is also really helpful. And just kind of remembering all of the accomplishments I've had in my life thus far and all the things that I'm grateful for. I always find that it's become sort of my anchor, all of those things, to bring me back to a healthy place of self-confidence.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And just to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey of self-confidence. What would be that one tip you would give to her?
I can't say this enough, but I would definitely advise every woman out there to just stay focused on positive self-talk and taking care of yourself. We've said this before already in this podcast, but women spend so much time caring for other people and putting other people before ourselves. But we really do our best in giving back to the world and giving to others when ourselves are full and we can really trust and learn in ourselves and love in ourselves. I think the world is full of people and things and opportunities to find yourself being put down, to have your influence and your role downplayed, to have your body picked at and your insecurities picked at. And we don't need any more of that going on in our own heads, bringing us down. And I think a lot of times we're our own worst critic too and our hardest judge. So it can be hard sometimes to focus on self-talk, positive self-talk, and to just carve out that time to take care of yourself. But that stuff is so crucial, and it's really not the little things. Those are the things that can be the end all for building your self-confidence.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing those tips. And, you know, just if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do, or check out your blog, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Yeah, my blog is freshjess.com, and you can find me on social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook at Jess Estrada.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Jess, you can also head on over to thetaoofselfconfidence.com and search for Jess's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else we talked about. And I just want to thank Jess for taking the time to share her story with us. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Not a problem. It was an honor having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of another amazing woman's journey to self-confidence, and we'll catch you later. Bye for now.
Bye.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Get your free audiobook by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.